Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. It's pretty hard to tell me and Triangle Bob apart when you zoom in on our heads. You know, cause our animator didn't give us faces. You humans are quite different though. You have so many awesome facial features that really set you apart. So much so, that you even made an online book for all of your faces. It seems like many of you spend a lot of time on there. So does that mean you're actually addicted to Facebook and other social media sites? Let's find out. We should probably start by seeing how much time people spend on social platforms. After looking at a few different sources, it seems like the average person spends about 2 hours a day on social media. Over your lifetime, this could add up to about 5 years. According to one study, those 2 hours a day are mostly spent on sites like Facebook and YouTube, averaging about an hour and 15 minutes between them.
Hopefully they're watching Life Noggin.
Twitter didn't get that much love, averaging only about a minute a day. That all seems like a lot of time, but does that mean it's an addiction? Well, according to the American Psychiatric Association, addiction is a complex condition of the brain where a person has compulsive substance use despite there being harmful consequences. People with addiction tend to have an intense focus on what they're addicted to the point where it takes over their life. What makes it so hard to break an addiction is that it can change the way your brain is wired, giving you harsh cravings that make it difficult to stop. Studies of brain imaging have even shown changes in the areas of the brain that relate to judgment, decision-making, learning, memory, and behavior control. So is this what's happening with Facebook and social media? It's hard to say for sure. That being said, we are starting to give more credit to an addiction that might be pretty similar. Video games. That's because the American Psychiatric Association includes internet gaming disorders as disorders that require further research, but that can result in clinically significant impairment or distress. The World Health Organization has also added gaming disorders to their International Classification of Diseases, which is used by medical practitioners around the world to diagnose conditions. Now, online video games are obviously not the same as sites like Facebook, yet they do have similar social aspects. It's possible that in the future, we'll see health organizations also classify social media as a type of an addiction or disorder. Still, sites like Facebook do have quite a few qualities that make you want to come back to them. Through constant feeds that go on forever and giving you push notifications on your phone, social media sites try their best to keep you on their app or website. And if you leave, they want you to come back as quickly as possible. Google and Facebook further their reach by also being commonly used to sign in to other sites. Social media sites always seem to have a significant impact on how you feel, furthering your connection to them. According to a recent study, after removing positive posts from the feeds of over 680,000 Facebook users, people made less positive posts and more negative ones. When negative posts were removed from their feed, the opposite happened, suggesting that emotions can be contagious. No matter what, whether something is an official addiction or not, that doesn't mean that it won't have problems. If you feel like you're spending too much time on social media, or that it's taking away from other areas of your life, then it might be a good idea to use it less or take a break. So tell me, how much time do you spend on social media? Do you think you're addicted to it? Let me know in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video and you want to learn more about addiction, check out the video we did on just that. You'll get a better understanding of how our bodies get addicted to something and why it's so difficult to quit. Check it out to learn more. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.